So you get all the script approvals, I assume.
Drawing on him, this is love.
So how often do people just like walk up to you and say, hey, Detective Douche?
Every day.
I bet you
do. Every day. Yeah. I do love it. I do love it. And I knew, I was telling these guys earlier that the moment I read the pilot, and then we're sitting at the table reading, and those words came out of Tom Ellis's mouth. I was, they rung in my ears, and I was like, everyone's going to know me as that. It's great. Because he says it in such a way that
it's like,
sort of like imprints itself into your brain.
That we're going to do a Lucifer cover band just called Detective Douche.
Thank you. Thank you.
Okay, so Detective Dan is trying to be sensitive here, people. You know, we've seen him. His story, his arc has been pretty good. Mm-hmm. I mean, all things considered, you know, because we've seen the divorce from Chloe. We see him as maybe the bad guy because she saw him as the bad guy, and we saw everything from her point of view for a while. But then, as we work with Detective Dan and see what he can do. He's actually quite a likable guy, and you can see how they were together at first. Mm-hmm. How are we moving ahead, or can you tell us how we're moving ahead with the triangle that we have, seeing how Lucifer and Chloe are getting closer? Is Dan out that you know of? Or
Dan
is
not. He's not. Dan isn't out of the picture. Okay. You know. But he is forced to deal with the natural evolution of where the relationship is going, you know, and you see how he deals with that, how she deals with it. He's still very much in love with her, you know, and I think it's always going to be there. And it's great because they've done a really good job with, you know, writing scenes where there's just a moment where you see, wow, I see where they fit, you know, and then it's broken out. But one of the cool things I think that is happening this season is that they're sort of diving into the world before and understanding, you know, how they met and why they worked in the beginning. You know, so you see them as a younger couple in the beginning. So, you know, sort of going back a little bit to sort of fill in their story.
One of the things about Detective Dan is that he is just, you know, he's a flawed guy. He is not a perfect guy at all. He makes bad decisions.
Even though he looks like it.
He's just, you know, he makes bad decisions and he deals with the repercussions of those. Moving forward, how is his decision making? Any big mistakes or any big redemptions coming up for him?
Yes, yes, and yes.
Okay.
Through talking to Joe and Hildy, our executive producers and writers, one of the things they say is that in the writer's room, everyone loves to watch Dan suffer. So, and to do that because of the decisions he makes. So when asking what's up for season three, those are the things that they like to see suffer. That's going to happen. So, you know, I think you're going to see a lot more of the same, of him making big decisions for what he thinks the right reasons are, and then, you know, getting crushed emotionally, you know. And there's a new relationship with Trisha Helfer, you know, and you see how they connect and, you know, and how that evolves and where that goes to, you know, and the fact that he's sleeping with Lucifer's mom, awesome. You know.
And the goddess of creation.
Yeah, I know, right?
There has to be something emasculating about that at some point.
Not even, because she comes back for seconds. So obviously I did okay.
Exploring Lucifer as the stepson would be amazing.
Would be the ultimate stab in the back.
What would you say has been your favorite moment or scene so far?
I gotta tell you, I really love working with Tom and Lauren. Like, we have just the greatest time on all levels. Like, we're just a bunch of clowns. But I think the one that always sticks out in my head have you guys seen the pudding, the stole my pudding episode?
Yes.
Okay, that was it. Oh. Yeah. Working with Tom and that night, and then, you know, being taken over by the Celestial Blade, and, you know, practically wanted to kill him because he ate my pudding. It was really, really fun. You know, we had such a great time working. We were working in this amazing house in Vancouver, and it was cold. And it was Raina was a little bit sick, but we would just go off on each other and laugh. And I think both of us at the end of the night, Tom was like, this is why we do this job, is to have moments like that. Yeah, because we just had so much fun.
So what do you guys do when the camera's not off and you guys are horsing around now?
Ugh, all we do is horse around. All we do. I was just telling a story the other day. You know, we're all a bunch of pranksters, and we came back to LA to shoot. We were staying at a hotel next to the pier, which is where we were shooting. So I was like, hey, screw it. I don't need to be driven. I'll just get a bike from the hotel, and I'll ride the bicycle down the bike path and go. And so I did that, and it was beautiful, and I locked up my bike. And Lauren, while I was on set, called the hotel and was like, hi, yeah, I work on a show called Lucifer, and one of my actors is here, and he forgot the combination to his bike. Would you mind giving it to me? So they gave her the combination of the bike, and she totally stole it and hid it and filmed me go crazy looking for that bike, cursing her. Yeah.
One of the fun things to watch, I think, is Dan and Lucifer, who obviously are not natural compadres, right, but have built this sort of romance.
Yeah, it's strange, right?
Yeah, it's kind of fun to watch. Any more of that going on?
Definitely. But this time also more with, like I said, you know, he's... you know, we had that episode where earlier in the year where he says, you know, I'm not Detective Douche, I'm Detective Espinosa,
yeah,
all right? I'm a human being. He said that was his first moment to be like, boom. And now he does that a lot. And it's even funnier, like that banter, because now he has balls.
Yeah.
So he's like, go ahead, give me more.
Yeah.
You know?
Cool.
Thank you, guys.
All right. Thank you, guys.